Sun was shining once again here at Roy Kidd Stadium as day four of preseason camp has wrapped up. I am joined by assistant head coach and tight ends coach Tommy Zagorski. Coach, what's good?
Living the dream, man. Better than I deserve.
I'm glad to hear that. Coach, first things first, I want to talk about like the depth of the tight ends. We have six this year, two are seniors, we got a transfer junior, and then three freshmen. How does that help with such a balance?
Well, the big thing that you see with the tight end room is the maturation of those guys. You got two great leaders that are seniors in Clay and Dan Paul who have played for us, have had a great career here so far, looking to put the cherry on the top of their time here in Kernel Country. And then you add in a guy like Adam Valiga, who's a transfer guy, who's got 2 years eligibility left. He was a great pickup for us midway through the year last year. He was here for the spring, so he learned a ton. Excited about what he can do in the run game and the passing game. And then our young guys, our three freshmen are outstanding players that I am really, really excited to work with. We recruited those guys. Those are guys that going forward are people that we're going to be really proud of.
Coach, you're talking about the pass game. Everybody knows tight ends try to catch them, but I want to focus on the run game. How important are tight ends in the run game?
It's essential. If you can't block, you're not a real tight end. So all you guys that are voting out there, C-gap and D-gap players, they better be able to block in that area if they're going to be called a tight end. And our guys right now, I tell them as we're going through camp, they got to be lion hunters. You know, the way you go into it, you go into a lion's den, what are you going to do? You go in with a spear, are you going to tiptoe in there or are you going to go after it? And that's what our guys are doing right now in the run game, staying low, good pad level, and sustaining and finishing through the whistle.
One more question, Coach. We'll let you get out of here. I know we're going to have some new fans this year. They might not know about the juice guys and Kool-Aid guys. Why don't you take them through, you know, the difference and which one you prefer?
Obviously, I'm a juice guy through and through. The difference between juice and Kool-Aid, juice has got nutrients in it. It's going to give you something a little bit sustainable. Kool-Aid, you can make quickly. You can fake it until you make it. But the difference is you're not going to get it done. So Kool-Aid guys versus juice guys. We're looking for juice guys here in Kernel Country, ready to fire the cannon.
Coach, I'm always looking for the juice guys you bring in. Thank you very much.
Appreciate it, brother. Go Big E.
Fans now joined by senior tight end Dan Paul. Dan, about fourth day of practice, man. How's it going for you?
It's going well. How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Last year you had a great season, first team all OVC. You're picked preseason all OVC this year. You know, does that light a fire under you?
It does. It really does. It shows that other teams in the conference show respect towards us and that I respect them, and it's huge.
How's it been going? It's your third year round with Coach Tommy Zagorski. How's he been up in your game?
It's been going well. Blocking's been getting better. Just showing effort throughout every play has been a whole lot better.
You guys have a good mix this year. You and Clayton Schmerber, the seniors, we have in a junior transfer, but then two redshirt freshmen and a true freshman. Does that balance really help you guys out?
It really does, because last year we only had four, and then during the season it was just me and Schmerber. So that really helps coming in the season with the other guys, learning their roles and getting more reps.
Man, I'm going to let you go after this moneymaker question. You have one cartoon to watch for the rest of your life, Dan. What cartoon are you watching?
I have to go with Static Shock.
I like it. Static Shock was my jam back then. Dan, as always, appreciate your time, bud. Fans, don't forget, August 30th is the Colonels' home opener when they take on the Eagles of Moorhead State.